back. Well, our research team, as promised, is standing by to give you the list of top 10 stocks as we head into trade today. So let me very quickly start with them. Anuj, what would you be looking at today?
Sonia, I'm just focusing on a very interesting internal that I feel could happen. I could be wrong here, but that's my feeling about it. I think Yes Bank saw delivery buying of 1,400 crores yesterday. It opened, of course, 20% higher and then ended 30% higher. And Axis Bank saw delivery selling of about 400 crores. Now, my sense is that now with Sooty Stakes sale also out and having seen so much outperformance of Axis, there's a good chance of over the next few days, some money moving from stocks like Axis into stocks like Yes Bank. And you might see a slow re-rating for Yes Bank, of course. The caveat is, it should not see a repeat of what happened post the results. After that, it saw one-way slide. So there should not be any more negative news out of Yes Bank. That, I think, is the key. Unless that happens, I think there's a chance that perhaps you see some more re-rating in Yes Bank.
Okay, well, Jet Airways will also be on our radar today. One, because the board has approved the resolution plan, and two, because the numbers came through. Of course, the bigger focus will be on the resolution plan, but just on the numbers very quickly, revenue has been subpar at just about 1-odd%. The positive is that losses have come down. So the net loss is almost 600-odd crores. The expectation was a 1,090 crore loss. And after three quarters of 1,000 crore loss plus, this time around, losses have come down to 587 crores. But that was on expected lines because fuel expenses are also down. But more importantly, Lata, this will be negative today. The stock will be in the red. It's negative for minority shareholders. What has come through?
That's what I would think. There is a recast plan, which is per se a positive news. Sure. But the recast plan is, at the moment, Jet has 11.4 crore shares outstanding. The bankers are going to issue themselves another 11.4 crore shares. So they become the single largest shareholder with a 50%. Because the equity has expanded now into 22.8 crore shares, the stake of Naresh Goyal falls to 25.5% from 51, and the stake of Etihad falls from 24 to 12%. Now, basically, immediately, what does it mean? Of course, the lenders have to approve the plan, and there's an 8,500 crore funding gap that has been identified. That's also negative news. That has to be filled in with the equity guys bringing some equity and the lenders bringing loans. As well, I think Naresh Goyal's securities will be taken away by the banks because they are putting in more money. All further doses of credit is always given by banks only when they take away the securities of the promoter. So they will, in all probability, have 76% stake. They have their own 25-50 and they will have the securities of Naresh Goyal. So it's almost 76%. But the important part is the dilution. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, every minority shareholder who held maybe 10 shares is actually going to hold 5 shares in terms of value. So my sense is today there is going to be red on the screen.
Okay, today red on Jet Airways. Perhaps even a bit of a red on SBI as well. It's been a weak stock anyway. Sonal, ONGC's numbers?
The numbers look good, Anuj. Well, the operating profit margins expanded by 340 basis points sequentially. That is because of lower operating expenditure. The net realization in terms of crude also came in at $66.38 per barrel. That is a 10% increase, and that is a good news coming in. In fact, the gas realizations were also high, and so overall, the growth was led by higher realizations in both gas and the crude oil segment. Well, Deutsche Bank, while they have cut their estimates, they maintain a buy rating. They say that it has inexpensive valuation and sensitivity to oil prices is something they're watching out for. Citi, on the other hand, says that the revenues are in line, but EBITDA is a beat on account of lower than expected operating expenditure. They also think that there's a room for the government to bring down debt. Additionally, the crude is hovering around that $65 per barrel mark. So there are some positive cues coming in for ONGC.
Okay. But I guess Nestle, not a very a positive taste, Mangala?
Absolutely not a positive taste, Latha. Not as much as the revenue, which is a disappointment. It was the operational performance in an era of benign input costs that was a concern. So just to look at the revenue, close to around 2,900 crores. This compares with our poll of 2,935 crores. Domestic revenue at 12% was pretty much in line. The exports were muted. Exports to Nepal, Bangladesh, as well as UAE were muted. So which explains the miss on the revenue. But the EBITDA, that one came in at 614 crores. The street was working with a number upwards of 700 crores. Our own poll threw up a number of 731 crores. Margins, we were working with an expansion of 20-30 basis points. The company posted a contraction and margins came in at 21.2% versus 25%, and that was on account of higher other expenses. Other expenses jumped up by 31%. The management said they are supporting their new launches and stepping up marketing activities. The street would have given it a longer rope had the stock not been trading at 51 times FY20 earnings.
All right, Mangalam, thanks a lot for that. Important development from the PM office. Arun Jaitley will resume as finance minister once again from today. So that is important.
I think tenacity, isn't it?
Yes, I completely agree. I think to give it to him, and
it was coming because yesterday he called a meeting, said he would address the Reserve Bank on the 18th of February. So it looked like he's coming back in full force.
All right, that's official now. By the way, no longer sources. But Ekta, what about Glenmark?
Well, Glenmark, prima facie, looked like a good set of numbers. So the total revenue growth was around 16-odd%, led by India, which was up around 15-odd%, and US, which was up 16%. But on a low base, same time last year, US was down 40%. Margins were in line at 17-odd%. We were working with a poll of around 17.4%. Profit, however, was below estimates. The company is spinning off its innovation business, which contains basically 8 molecules under development, to a new company in the US, which will have a separate board and CEO. So the call is at 8:30 a.m. We'll get more details on all of these developments on the call.
All right, thanks a lot for that. Let's move on now. Voltas, let's find out how the numbers look. Anisha joins in to give us more. Hi, Anisha, morning.
Yeah, well, the AC business continues to be weak. The revenue there declined by 4%. The margins contracted by 400 basis points when it comes to the AC business. And that's the reason of the disappointment in the stock. But however, having said that, this was largely expected given the results we have seen from the other players as well. What drove the performance was the EMP segment, wherein the revenue jumped by around 16%. So overall, a mixed quarter from Voltas. Let's see which way the stock moves.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. So, not so cool, Voltas numbers. So, now you have a bunch of results on your radar.
Yes, absolutely. I'll start with Deepak Fertilizers. The numbers were very weak. The profits declined around 99% on a YY basis. The volumes did not pick up, and that's why the revenues were also lower this time. MEP Infra also weak set of numbers. Net profit decline of 36% is not something that the street would like. Aluvalia Contracts was a margin miss. Well, the contract work margins, they saw a significant dip. They came in at 12.4% versus 17% on a YY basis. McLeod Russell saw a EBITDA margin decline of around 622 basis points on a sequential basis. Moving on, India Bulls Real Estate, while the numbers look good sequentially and on a YY basis, remember the applicability of Ind AS 115 will make the numbers look lumpy. Also, the company has not given any details in terms of pre-sales, rental income, and also the debt figure. So let's see which way the stock moves today.
Okay, so largely negative news, right? Sonal, Sonia, can you cheer up?
Yeah, unfortunately not. Not with EverReady for sure, because the numbers, actually there was a huge fall in profits this time around because of a one-time exceptional cost of 23-odd crores, a workman separation cost, they called it. But even if you strip that off, the numbers are really lackluster. Hardly any revenue growth of 2%, EBITDA, you know, flat, margins flat. More importantly, the management commentary was quite cautious. They said they're on course to monetize their non-core assets, but I must remind our viewers that they still have very high promoter pledge. 45% of promoter stake is pledged currently, and that has been, you know, a bit of a concern. I did check with them on several things, liquidity issues, etc. There was really no concrete answer. So I reckon the stock could be under pressure today.
Oh, okay. That's not a very good sign at all. JK Tyres and...
some good news. JK Tyres numbers were good. In fact, the India business strength continues, and the Mexico business, which is the Tornel subsidiary, that has reported an EBIT profit of 42 crores versus a loss of 16 crores same time last year. So just to take you through the consolidated numbers, revenue growth of 29%, EBITDA growth of 24%. Margins were slightly under pressure because of higher raw material costs, which was, you know... petro-based raw materials, the company called it. However, the profits went up almost two times to about 27-odd crores. The truck and bus radial tyres saw a 30% volume growth in 9 months of FY19. So pretty good numbers coming in from JK Tyres. But let's go across to Reema now and find out what are the other stocks in the news this morning. Hi, Reema. Morning.
Hi, Sonia. Good morning. Well, I've got five stocks on my radar. Let me start with Emami, where reports suggest that KKR is looking to infuse about 2,000 crore rupees. Positive for Emami because it will help in bringing down their debt. For sugar stocks, it's a boost because the government has hiked the MSP or minimum selling price by 2 rupees per kg, which now makes the price at 31 rupees per kg. So considering that the millers have been, have been sitting on very high cane arrears, it will be a boost. A bitter dose for Divi's Laboratory because there are IT searches in their offices in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, according to reports. For GMR, there is a board, they're setting up a committee where they will consider and evaluate options for demerger and to unlock shareholder values. And finally, Minda Industries, because they will be acquiring Harita Seating, it's likely to be via a share swap. Back to you.
All right, thanks a lot for that. Here's a quick recap of our top stocks to watch. Stocks with positive news flow today: ONGC, Glenmark, India Bulls Real Estate, JK Tyres, Imami, Balrampur Chini, Bajaj Hindustan, Triveni Engineering and GMR Infra. While stocks with negative news flow this morning: Jet Airways, Nestle, Voltas, Deepak Fertilizers, MEP Infra, Aluvalia Contracts, McLeod Russell, Everready and Divi's Labs.